Yo, what's up YouTube? It's me, Dimension JJD here, and today we're going to be making some metal haired art. And this was actually a suggestion from the Prodchies Discord server, and I wanted to do this tutorial showing on the basics and the way I found it most entertaining to do this. So we are going to hop right into Blender. So once here, we're just going to load a new general file. So yeah, we have our cube, which is going to be the base to what we're going to do today. So we're going to go from object mode to edit mode. You can do it also by hitting tab, and once on edit mode, we're going to right click on our cube and we're going to subdivide it a bunch of times just so it's nice and subdivided like a freaking magma block. Maybe not so much. Alright, I think that's good. I recommended doing like about 5 times. And we're going to probably later going to need to subdivide in mode. So we go right into from layout to sculpting, and here we're going to search for the grab tool. We can also just press G to select it, and once here we just hit right click, we move the radius down to something about 25, 32, something around there. And we're going to put this strength all the way up on 1. So now that we have those settings applied, we're going to start grabbing points from our cube. We're going to start stretching them as far as we can. I recommend to zoom out a little, not too much, because the radius increases, at least on this version of Blender that I'm using, which is not the latest, so keep that in mind. So whatever your camera is pointing, that's where all of your points are gonna go. So if I were to grab this point and stretch it, it's going to go to where my camera was pointing, so there. So just be careful with that and just start grabbing points at random. Doesn't matter if it glitches a little, like here for example, it doesn't matter if it does that. That can be fixed. And also add some cool little effects to our art. Going to keep grabbing here. Just make sure to grab it from pretty much all sides. Again, doesn't matter if you grab it and it ends up in a weird position of this, can be fixed. And yeah, just have fun doing this a little while. Remember, hit Ctrl C if you think that something looks goddamn awful. Damn, that's a big one. I'm just going to delete that one and just move it again. I think that might be just it. It looks like a mess, but trust me, it's gonna be worth it. So now we go back to layout mode. We hit gotta make sure we're looking this from afar. We're going to hit S. We're going to sculpt it down, to scale it down a little, just so it doesn't, it's a big of an eyesore, if you know what I mean. Then we're going to modifier properties. Here we add a simple deform, turn this to 360 degrees, and just start playing with the axle, with the axis, start playing with the modes until you find something that you like. Remember that you can always duplicate it. And now if you see that it starts glitching this much, just hit tab again to go into edit mode, and once here just click on the vertices, subdivide it a few times, but beware because this might cause some lag on your system. So if your PC is not that good, and we go back to object mode, and here we can continue doing some stuff. I recommend changing the axis, like about here, and switching the mode to bend, maybe work. This one looks epic. You can even the color axis. We then add a taper. Now this will need more subdividing, but I think this is already looking pretty nice. Yep, I think this is enough. So we're going to go on to camera view, and we're going to output properties. See if I can find it. Yeah, output properties. I'm already there. And we're going to set it to 1000 by 1000 pixels. If you want, you can do 2000 by 2000, but again, that might lag you a lot. And we go back to the camera view. We're going to grab on here. Here's this little arrow. We're going to grab it, just move it until you can read pretty much everything. And we're going to go to view. We're going to put camera to view. I'm going to select the camera. We're going to go to the camera properties here, object data properties. We're going to move our focal length to something about 10 millimeters. That's cool, I think. And from here, just by zooming in with your mouse and moving the camera with your mouse, just pick a cool place. Again, if you don't like how the cube looks, just add some more modifiers, or just change the already existing ones. So now this one I think looks better, so just pick a good angle, and I think that will be okay. Alright, so now we're going to go to viewport shading, and we're going to work with some little shading, really basic shading. So we're going to go to word properties. We're going to change the color to total darkness, or black if you know what I mean. Then we're going to select the light, and we're going to press G, I think it was. Yeah, G, and we're going to move the light a little more towards us. So yeah, move the light. I forgot I was on the camera mode, so let me just turn that down. We're going to press G. Going to move it closer to the camera so we have a good view of whatever we are having here. So maybe move with just a little bit more. I think that might be good enough. it doesn't really matter how it end up, like how the lights end, where you place the light. That's what I'm trying to say. God damn it, speak, motherfucker. I mean, and yeah, just pick a side that has good illumination. Oh, maybe this one can help to place the light closer. I think that to go back to camera. Right, maybe not. Light, come back. God damn, this is taking a little bit more than what I had expected. So here's a video of a puppy or something, I don't know. Whatever the hell I put here, so yeah, you know what, screw it. All right, I think that's enough. And now we're going to go to the render properties. We're going to add ambient occlusion, bloom, and screen space reflection. So yeah, that's it. And now we're going to select cube. We're going to material properties. And we're going to change the color to, I don't know, something that you like. Maybe a teal, maybe a pink, maybe a purple, whatever you like. Once you have selected it, just go to the metallic, make it a little bit more metallic. Doesn't matter if you do it all the way or not. And we're going to take out the roughness, and we're going to put it all the way down. Make another little bit more metallic mess here. And I'm going to go out of the camera view. I'm going to just move the light a little bit closer to the whole shebang. And we're going back to camera mode. I'm just going to move it a little bit more till we have a little bit of light reflections there. Maybe making the color brighter will help. So I'm gonna do that. And I think that works really well. Again, just pick a side that you like. Think a good idea will be to add a little bit of emissions. Maybe not that many. And just changing the color to our base color. Emissions are not gonna work. So I think this might be as good as we can get it to be. I'm not really that happy with the results. But again, maybe that's just, like, I don't know, maybe the lighting, we can make the light stronger. Alright, so I think I made a little bit of improvements. I just moved the light closer to the metal hair thingy, and I think it now looks better. So I'ma just hit F12 and I'm going to export it. So I'll be back again. All right, so we're back now in Photoshop, and here is our export. So the first thing I'm going to actually do to it is going to add a gradient map. So I'm going to search for some different gradients. Adobe already has some ones that are okay-ish, but if you want to, you know, import your ones, go ahead. It's your computer, not mine. So and I'm just searching for something that I kinda like, and I'm going to, you know, just modify it a bunch. Neutral. I think I'm going to start modifying this one. So first of all, it's just going to pick colors at random. You can add whatever color you like. It's your decision, not mine. So now I know it looks a little bit crooky and stuff. It doesn't look good, but hey, we're going to make it look good. So don't click off the video yet. We can start adding a little bit more of deep blue colors, a bit more greenish. Alright, I think that's okay. Now we're going to just change the blending mode of it to, I don't know, something like hard light, maybe this one, and so overexposed. I don't know. I have my Photoshop in Spanish. I'm sorry, guys. I wanted to put it on English, but I had to reinstall it, so I'm sorry for that. So I'm just going to put it on this one, and I'm going to just grab my logos, put on some lettering, you know, average things. All right, so once here, first thing I'm going to do is adding some text. So right, we can start, I don't know, typing whatever. So I'm actually going to just type whatever. And from here, I know it doesn't look that good still, but this is the part I really like, so we're going to add another layer, specifically a fill layer. So in my case, it's called Capa de Relleno. That's his name in Spanish, so I'm just going to put it like this. And I'm going to add some noise. Make it an intelligent object. And then I'm just going to move the opacity a little bit down. This already makes it look 10 times better. I think that this one could use a little bit more purple, just to add that kind of early 90s aesthetic and stuff. Anyways, I think this might make it look better. Maybe if I were to move the whole thing about, yeah, kind of makes it look a little bit more better. Now I'm going to rasterize, or more likely convert into a smart object over text. I'm going to duplicate it. Once duplicated, I'm going to add a little bit of what is it called? Gaussian. Yeah, I don't remember the names in English. I'm sorry. Gaussian blur, what's called. I'm sorry again. I didn't talk that actually speaking another language was going to be such a challenge to making these videos. But hey, look at where we are now. Making sick cover art with the Hispanic guy. God damn it. I'm going to just hold on. Right, I think I have selected both, so I'm going to I don't want to let my microphone fall to the ground. This thing caused me an eye of my face, so I'm going to try to put it as silently as possible. I still think I made a lot of noise. Oh, going to make this smaller to move it around here. Maybe I will try to put a color layer here. Maybe some setting. A little color overlay, where is it? Freak. Found it already. Just make the color. God damn it, this looks fire. Unintentional fire, like. God damn it. Alright. I think that will be all for today. I was planning on adding my logo to this, but this already looks sick. This already looks sick. So I hope this has already... Well, I hope this has helped you, at least in some way. And if not, I'm sorry, I'm bad at this. It's my first video ever, so I hope that at least I made you giggle a little. So, hey, it's been a pleasure. What can I say, man? See you next time.